Hello students, you are welcome to Mathematics with Dr. OJ once again. Today we shall also talk about Lebesgue's Major and Theory of Integration. So we are continuing with solutions to from tutorial problems or questions in Lebesgue's Major and Theory of Integration. So in this video, we want to show that if x is a non-intercept and a, b are subset of x, then a difference b is equal to x difference, open bracket, x difference a union b, close the bracket. Now, these questions are elementary and very, very simple. But if you don't know the right approach to them, you will miss it. Okay? So, if you look at the right hand side of the given equation, I can start by saying that from the right hand side, of the given equation, x difference a is automatically going to drop a complement. Okay? Now, if we now plot there, if we replace f difference a in the right hand side with a complement, so we're going to have what's now, therefore f difference a union b will now become what? A complement union b. Okay. Very simple and clear enough. Now, by the time you bring what you have there into the right hand side again, this will lead you to, this implies x difference, everything in the bracket now has been reduced to a complement union b. Okay? So, and from the knowledge of complementation of set, if I say from x difference a is equal to a complement, what do I have here? So automatically, we can have x difference a complement, union b will be a complement union b all complement, and so which is going to be using the adipotent law, complement, that was A. Okay, then when you apply complementation on the union, it becomes an intersection. So by the time you bring the complementation on B, what do you have? You have B complement. So which is the same thing as A difference B. So looking at this, compare it with what you have on the left hand side. So hence, a difference b, which you have originally in the equation given, is now equal to a difference b. So the proof is complete. So let's look at another problem. We are still talking about some basic theoretical problems in major theory. So let's look at this. The second question: Show that. If the column E is a sigma algebra, in X, then the algebra generated, by E when in an intersection of the subset of that particular sigma algebra is taken is going to be equal to E. I hope you remember really what sigma of our algebra here means. So it is set of the intersection. This sigma of E itself means our algebra generated by all the sigma algebras together with the intersection of the subset in that particular algebra. Okay, so with this now, I want to show that this is equals to this. Now let's look at how to do about this. Okay, now it will say that let sigma I be all sigma algebras in X. So let sigma I be all that is. So clearly from here, remember we say it's a set of all sigma algebras that intersects with a subset in that particular space X, in that set X. So now we have to let this column E be all sigma algebras in that X. So automatically, clearly here, the intersection of this sigma algebras is I moving from 1 to infinity will be what? Will contain element of that sigma algebra. Okay? We contain that. I hope you understand. So with this, we are only showing the solution to the problems. So also, the union of all these sigma algebra, okay, will give us a sigma algebra. Okay, and the intersection of all the sigma algebra, why I move from 1 to infinity, we call it the intersection of the sigma algebra. Okay, now hence the intersection of all the sigma algebra as I move from 1 to infinity, intersecting with sigma algebra itself, simply means sigma algebra intersecting sigma algebra, and that the sigma algebra. So that implies that from what we have here, that implies the algebra, the sigma algebra generated by all sigma algebras without the intersection of subset that particular sigma algebra will be equal to the sigma algebra. So it's as simple as that. Now let's look at another problem. Another problem here. So let's find the sigma algebra generated by the intersection of all the sigma algebra together with K, which happens to be a subset in that sigma algebra. We have to find that sigma algebra that's generated as a result of the intersection of K with all the sigma algebras in X. So, for when K is a set of null sets, and when K is equal to the entire set, it's a set of the entire set. So, how do we go about it? Let's look at this. It's not difficult. Okay, it's not difficult to do. So, what do we do here? Let X be a non-empty set, and K be a subset. Let K be a subset of, it is all subsets of, this is power set of X, it's all subsets, all possible subsets in X. So that means K be a subset there. Now, let sigma I, that is a curly bracket I, be all sigma algebras in X. Let that be all sigma algebras in X. Now, from our previous solution, you can say that the union of the power, all the power subset of X is equal to X, yes. And X itself, according to one of the axioms of algebra, X must be in the algebra, okay? So, which implies that the union of all the power sets of x, should equally be there. Because if this is equal to x and x is equal, that means this is equal to, I mean, this is this algebra. So now, the you know, the set of all the signal algebras in x intersecting k is virtually the sigma algebra, which means k is in that sigma algebra. You look at it. So, which implies the sigma, the set of all the sigma algebra generated by k is now equal to the set of all the sigma algebra intersecting our k. I hope you understand that. So, from here, the sigma algebra generated by k will be the union of all the subsets, okay, of x intersecting k. So, which brought the union of all the subsets intersecting the set of null sets, because we have to find R of, I mean, the sigma algebra generated by k for when k has its, you know, the set of non-empty set. So here we will have the sigma algebra generated by k will be equal to empty set. Okay. Now, you know, when our k now is a set of the entire hex. Okay. Now, since the sigma algebra generated by k is equal to the union of all the power sets intersecting k, then, you know, then the union of all the power sets intersecting k, intersecting what? Intersecting our entire set x. So, the sigma algebra generated by k now from here, you know, will now be x intersecting x, which is going to be x. So, that is that, that as well. So don't forget to subscribe to my video channel and click the notification bell so that each time I upload a video, you will be notified. Thanks and God bless you.